evening, everybody, and welcome to your Jubilant Saturday Part 2, Episode 670. Today's Daily Bread passage, we're going to be talking about a life of integrity. From Wynn Collier, derived from Proverbs 11, 1 through 5. So if you're excited about this one, smash your like button. Just smash it. Give it a good old smasheroo. comment something you did today or are going to do this weekend. And whose birthday and anniversary is today? You got somebody close to you. Who's somebody that you are kin with, like family members or close-knit friends, that you would like me to wish them a happy birthday or happy anniversary? But subscribe if you do, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends. Help me reach that 100 subscriber mark by April the 18th, which is 23 days away. Without further ado, and as of recording this, I haven't been to the parade yet, but I will be sure to let you know how the parade went in tomorrow's videos. In your Sunday videos, I'll let you know how it went. So. Because sometime later tonight, I'll record it, and then I'll be able to tell you how it went. First time I've been in a parade since I was little. I ain't had to be involved in something since I was little. When our church did one in the Leesburg, I think it was a Christmas parade, because we went, some of us little kids went, they built boxes like a present, and we wore the box over us like we were walking presents. I still remember that many years ago. A Life of Integrity from Wynn Collier. He writes, Abel Mutai, M-U-T-A-I, Mutai, however it's pronounced, who is a Kenyan runner competing in a grueling international cross-country race, was mere yards from victory, his lead secure, and confused by the course's signage and thinking he had already crossed the finish line. However, Mutai stopped short. The Spanish runner in second place, Ivan Fernandez Anya, saw Mutai's mistake rather than take advantage and bolt past for the win. However, he called up to Mutai, put out his arm and guided Mutai forward to a gold medal win. And when reporters asked Anya why he purposely lost the race, he insisted that Mutai deserved the win, not him. So what would be the merit of my victory? What would be the honor of that medal? What would my mom think of that? And as one report put it, Anya chose honesty over victory. There's a lot of good people out there that the guy just misunderstood where he was. And that happens. A foreigner from another country doesn't recognize the signage of where they're supposed to go on a race. That's gonna happen. And instead of the second place guy saying, "Oh, he's slowing down. I can pass him and win," and he writes self-righteous. Person like that would have took off and won the race. But that guy was not. He was not self-righteous. The guy that was there win the race because he had had it insecure, but he mistook a sign, didn't realize where he was. And so he chose to help him get to the line. But, oh, you're not there yet. Come on. You got a few more meters to go. Come on. You deserve this win because you were out there. So Proverbs says that those who desire to live honestly, who want their lives to display faithfulness and authenticity, make choices based on what's true rather than what's expedient. So the integrity of the upright guides them in Proverbs 11, verse 3. This commitment to integrity isn't the only right way to live, but it also offers a better life. So the proverb continues in verse 3, but the unfaithful are destroyed by their duplicity. So in the long run, this honesty never pays. So if we abandon our integrity, short-term wins actually yield defeat. But when fidelity and truthfulness shape us in God's power, we slowly become people of deep character who lead generally good lives. Amen? That's right. We should lead good lives, not... We should lead the life that God wants us to lead, not what we want to lead, or not what the world wants us to lead. You get that? But where's your integrity being tested right now? And what are the choices before you, and how do they increase or decrease your integrity? Ponder those questions by saying this, which should be on the screen. Make sure your subtitles are on so you can see them. God of integrity, you're honest and faithful. Make me more like you. Teach me how to live uprightly. Okay. So your Bible reading today is Joshua 22, 23, and 24. And Luke chapter 30. The whole chapter. So coming up tomorrow in your Sunday Daily Bread passage, which will be probably about 1:45 tomorrow, for Sunday, March 27th, 2022, a glorious Lord's Day Sunday, episode 671, part 2, we're going to be talking about the essence of prayer from Bill Crowder, derived from 1 Peter 5, 6 through 11. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that sometime later today. But you'll see that tomorrow. And just before I go off, coming up, we're going to be talking about tomorrow morning. We'll be talking about It's All About God, number 38, in episode 671, part 1, talking about God's grace is sufficient. And then we'll talk about the essence of prayer in part 2. And then in your Turning Point video tomorrow, we're going to be in the fourth and final installment of the Timing is Everything weekend series. And episode 196, we're going to be talking about In the Fourth Watch. Fourth video, fourth watch. Just a coincidence. We're going to be starting with Matthew 14:25, which we'll read in the recommended reading 14:22-33. The turning point is from Laura Story, S-T-O-R-Y, and your weekend reading, hopefully you read two chapters today and two tomorrow. 1 Samuel chapters 15, 16, 17, and 18. So read 15 and 16 today, and then the other two tomorrow, just to spread them out. So. But we'll see that one and the other two tomorrow. So with that said, I love you, I appreciate you, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your jubilant Saturday evening, and come back tomorrow for another Lord's Day Sunday. And the last Lord's Day Sunday of March. So, with that said, see ya. Goodbye.